What is statistical process control? Well, in the DMAIC process, it's DMAIC, and the C stands for control. So once we've made an improvement, we want to sustain that new level of performance. And this is often where most groups fail, is to implement a way to measure and monitor that. And so what we want to know with statistical process control, or SPC, is the process stable? And by that, I mean, is it consistent? Is it predictable? Can we count it to deliver what we want? And then, is it capable of meeting customer requirements? So this is about, does the process consistent? And this is, does it meet customer specifications? Now, what do we use to do that? Well, for stability, we're going to use control charts. And so we're going to have our process over time, and it's going to have a center line, and an upper control limit, and a lower control limit, your UCL and an LCL, and these are all calculated from your data. So this is based on how your data performs. You know, and if we have some point that's actually out of spec up here, we want to know that, because that means it's not stable. There's a special cause. And we might want to come in and do some root cause analysis on why did that happen. Ask five whys. From the capability standpoint, we're going to use histograms on variable data. And so if we have a histogram, and we have a lower spec limit, and an upper spec limit, we want to know, does our process fit between these two goalposts? Or is it shifted off to one side? Or does it span too much? Do we need to narrow it? And the goal here is to get it to the point where it meets customer specifications. Because there's actually a cost. The more you move away from your target value here, there's an incurred cost. And that's what's actually called the Taguchi loss function. He found that as you move away from your target value, there's a cost to society in dollars. And the further away you get, the greater the cost. So obviously, these are things we want to avoid, right? And we want to get to the point where it's very centered. And Six Sigma, we'd end up with a CPK, CP and CPK, of that are greater than or equal to 2. And so that's our goal, is to find ways to make our process stable and capable. And if our process starts to do something wiggy, like shift and go up, then we want to be able to detect that and take some action to correct that and bring it back in line. Or if we need to move this, we need to move that, maybe reduce our variation. Those are all things we can do with statistical process control. And once you get above a 3 sigma level, you really can't detect changes without these, right? So when you get to 4 sigma, 5 sigma, 6 sigma, you are going to have this in place to sustain that new level of performance. Otherwise, you'll just drift back into being a normal 3 sigma company with lots of mistakes and rework and error and problems. All right? And you can do this, it doesn't matter if it's in manufacturing or services, you can measure time, you can measure defects, you can measure sample sizes, all kinds of things will be handled with statistical process control. And the QI macros make that easy. So that's statistical process control, a stable process, a capable process that meets customer expectations. And just keep doing that, make it better over time. Eventually, you know, we'd like to get to the point where there's no variation, but that's probably not going to happen. And this is how we monitor it, with statistical process control. So learn how to use these tools. Be a money belt.